A plane without a pilot, or a pilot without a plane. The second way is a jetpack. You put it on, turn it on, and fly. A dream that has long been stuck in people's heads and in science fiction. A dream that couldn't reach practice. Despite all the attempts, for a long time, no one has been able to make a real jetpack that could really be used. And then a guy from somewhere in England appeared and declared, "I did it." So what did he make? A predecessor to the Iron Man suit or another toy? Let's get to know this device, understand its prospects, and think about whether it can become a new word in travel. Or perhaps a military game changer. The gravity jet suit is on the horizon. The story of this incredibly cool device should start with its creator. This is Richard Browning, at first glance an ordinary guy from Great Britain. Family, education, military service, there was nothing particularly amazing in his biography. Hobbies, sports and aviation. The first because it is useful and good, the second hereditary. Grandfather was a pilot, father was an aircraft engineer. And at some point studying the capabilities of the human body intersected with the passion for flying and something curious was born. While the entire industry is being automated as much as possible, removing functionality from humans right down to unmanned systems, Browning, on the contrary, decided to minimize the amount of equipment, leaving it only in aspects that humans are physically incapable of performing. This is how the idea of a jet suit appeared, but not quite the way everyone is used to imagine it. The concept assumed that the pilot would retain maximum functionality. No wings, no complex systems, drives, or separate controls. The engines were to be attached to the limbs that directly controlled the flight. No pedals or side sticks. If you want to turn, turn your hand. What fly-by-wire could be better than what is in your head? This was supposed to allow not only to abandon a large number of parts, making everything lighter and simpler, but also to make the controls more sensitive. Seeing the prospects, Browning gathered a small team of enthusiasts and began work. Here you can laugh. What an innovation. I remember a certain genius, billionaire, playboy philanthropist with a very similar idea. But we're not discussing the idea here, but its implementation. The implementation was not without adventures. At first, it was necessary to select the engines, and the choice was in general small. Piston engines are heavy and not powerful enough, and you can't put propellers on hands. So they settled on jet engines. Light, compact, and powerful. Fortunately, such engines have been on the market for a long time, thanks to the RC aircraft fans. Of course, they were expensive, noisy, and voracious, but they do their job. The engines were attached to simple metal frames and were put on arms and legs. And it wasn't easy. The engines, located on the side, apparently created torque that twisted the limbs. In addition, the engines on the legs were close to the ground and burned everything the pilot was standing on. Moreover, there was a constant risk of the exhaust from the upper engines getting into the air intakes of the lower ones, which didn't help them at all. As a result, the engineers decided to abandon the engines on the legs and move them to the back, while putting a pair on each arm to give the pilot reliable support. Well, what can I say? Iron Man didn't get everything working right away either. The rest of the equipment, in accordance with the concept, was minimal. Regulators on the hands, a small fuel tank on the back, and basic automation with batteries on the chest. Plus protection and a helmet, like those of motorcyclists. From the outside, of course, it all seemed like playing around. I can easily imagine people, with a smart look, recommending that they find a real job. Although the impression could have been in part true. The guys were clearly having a blast. In 2017, the team of garage engineers began to transform into something more serious. Wired magazine and Red Bull became partners, plus venture investors. Were you expecting BAE Systems and Lockheed Martin? At least at the initial stage, this was enough for Gravity Industries to appear officially and continue their work. The appearance of more serious resources allowed them to implement the ideas more efficiently. The engines were replaced with more powerful ones. Those on the arms now produce a thrust of up to 22 kg force each, while the pair of engines on the back were replaced with one, with a thrust of about 56 kg force. The total power of the engines reached 1,050 horsepower, like the Bugatti Veyron. The materials have also been improved. Now there is a lot of carbon. Plus, a compact onboard computer and indicators on the helmet glass appeared. Before, a lot had to be done manually, and the status of the elements had to be checked by lights on the chest. Not very convenient in active flight. This whole design turned out to be well controlled and quite reliable. There were no serious incidents, although just in case they tried to fly low. Flight data: pilot weight up to 85 kilograms, speed about 60 kilometers per hour, flight time on average 8 minutes. Not much, but this is already something you can fly and not just jump. This speed, by the way, is not the maximum. In 2019, a pilot managed to accelerate to 136 kilometers per hour, which is about 73 knots. Not bad. And it works. The suit is simple, light, and comfortable. Gravity is already flying them a lot, and the number of people who have tried it is growing. And these are not only pilots and testers, but also simpler people like company guests and bloggers, which means that it is not that difficult to master. The flight duration is short, but the company is working on it with some success. The only factor that is confusing comes from its bonus. The frame of the aircraft is the person itself, which means that he experiences certain loads. For long flights, the pilot will have to be quite enduring. I do not exclude that some kind of exoskeleton may appear, at least on the hands. Not Iron Man, of course, but futuristic. Another problem is money. The price tag for a suit by the early 2020s exceeded $400,000. Not a cheap pleasure. The prospect is that we are talking about individual production for now, and with the start of serial production they can become cheaper. Although probably not by much. It has 5 jet engines, which, no matter how you look at it, can hardly be cheap. Gravity promises $250,000 for a serial device. We'll see how they cope with this challenge. Interestingly, Gravity is also working on an electric version, with 6 fans in large nacelles. First thought, okay, they are going electric too. With the corresponding problems, less power, long charging time, and the best part in aviation, heavy batteries. Current electric prototypes can fly at most for a minute, and if you install sufficiently powerful batteries, the suit will weigh hundreds of kilograms, which will put an end to the whole concept. A person simply cannot carry that much. Nevertheless, there is a use for current devices. Electric engines are cheaper, quieter, and most importantly safer than jet engines. An electric jetpack can be very useful, for example at the early stages of training. Full-scale flights have not yet begun, these are often just jumps on a platform. High power is also not needed, and power can be supplied simply by a cable, removing the batteries. It turns out simple, quiet, safe, and much more cheap, but only a simulator for now. And now a provocative question. The device is of course cool, but what is it for? Talented guys created an interesting thing, travel around the world and put on a show. And at a price of $250,000, it seems like a toy for rich thrill seekers. But you shouldn't immediately write it all off as simple fun. Yes, Gravity Industries is a small team with limited capabilities. The project is raw, but let's not forget that less than 10 years ago, it was an engine put on a hand, connected by a hose to a bucket of fuel. Progress is obvious. If this was a project by a large corporation, it is possible that they would have spent $1 billion on it already, and the result would be a promise to show something by 2035. And as for the frivolousness, well, at the stage of inception, aviation was also quite a circus. And now, while initially the project seemed like simple fun, with development and expansion of capabilities, options began to appear. The first, of course, has not gone anywhere. Spectacular and extreme sports, even races have already been organized. Another option, Gravity is actively demonstrating its brainchild to various medical and rescue services, for which it can become a useful tool, when you need to quickly get somewhere in areas where there are problems with infrastructure. The same can be said about many other services, police, patrols, coast guard, monitoring of natural resources, and so on. And finally the site, the manifestation of which was awaited by special people, the military. a suit that allows soldiers to be deployed individually in cramped conditions without using airplanes and helicopters sounds tempting. Again, if the military is interested, the issue of high cost may not be so critical. With mass production, the price will fall. And we are talking about customers whose artillery shells can cost up to $70,000. At the moment, there is no information about orders, but the military is clearly actively interacting with the jetpack creators. Gravity Industries are innovators, trying to invent and implement something new, and not just with promises and presentations, but with a real device. This alone is a reason to applaud them. Will they succeed? Who knows? Maybe yes, maybe no. Of both technical and economic risks, there is still a mountain to break through. And then, who knows? Maybe in 10 years, a guy in a jetpack will seem commonplace. Except, of course, I would like this guy to have rescue equipment or sports awards, and not just a machine gun. Like and subscribe to the channel so as not to miss new videos. There are still a lot of interesting things on the horizon.